Good morning, everyone. My name is Tanushree Dalai from Civil Engineering branch, and today I am going to teach you about your Theory 1 paper, which name is Structural Mechanics. So before I will go into your subject in details, I think you need to know some basic about your subject. So in the introduction part, we'll start from your introduction part. So in introduction part, you have to know three things. So first thing is why it is called as structural mechanics, and second thing is what is the objective of this subject, and third thing is what you will gain from this subject. So the first question is why it is called as structural mechanics. So first of all, the structural mechanics, nothing but it is a combination of two things. One is structural and another is mechanics. Okay, so the first part, the structural part, it is comes from the word structure. Okay, structure means it is a combination of one to many structural members. Okay, when a many structural members merge together, it form a unit in the form of a structure. Okay, when different structural members merge together, it form a unit in the form of a structure. So there are many kinds of members are there, like your horizontal member, vertical member, and inclined member. So the horizontal member is known as your beam structure, and vertical member is known as column member, then inclined member is known as strut. Okay, as you can see in this figure, it is a structure of a building. Okay, so now you can see the vertical member here, the horizontal member is here, and the slab member is here, which is the your placed in the roof and floor section. Okay, and this is the foundation of the whole building. Okay, then next thing is your mechanics part. Okay, mechanics is nothing but it is the mechanism of any structural member present in a structure. So when mechanism part of a member is performed, then how it react against the loading system, how it behave against the loading system, these are you have to analyze in this part. So the reaction of the structure against the loading system you can find out here. Then how a structure is deformed when it is subjected to loading system, you can learn from this subject. And behavior of the structure along its whole lifespan under the loading system, you can find out from this mechanism part. Then second thing is what is the objective of this subject. Okay, so the first objective is to determine the value of deformation under the loading system. Okay, it can be find out by derivation part. Okay, this subject carries a various kinds of derivation part. Okay, so your derivation part is depending upon two things. So first thing is the loading system, types of loading system on a structure, and second thing is at what distance the load is situated. So these two factor is affected, and it is helpful to determine the value of deformation. So next and third thing is what you will gain from this subject. The first thing you will gain that the knowledge about the behavior of a structure under various loading system. The second thing you will gain the stages of variation of a structure with respect to the time of its whole lifespan. And the third thing you will get, the variations of the structure depends upon the types of materials used in the structure. Okay, so these three things all about your introduction part. Now you will learn about the whole chapter 1. Okay, we will start from the chapter 1. So first thing is structural mechanics. So first of all, the structural mechanics, or it can also called as mechanics of structure, it is the computation of deformation, deflection, and internal forces or stresses within structures, either for design or for performance evaluation of existing structure. So now you can see here the deformation part is there, and another here is a deflection part is there. So deformation, what is the meaning of deformation? So whenever a subject or whenever a material subjected to a loading part, it will be deflect or it change its position from one set to another set. So the deformation is the value of change of the structure is known as the deformation part, and deflection part means the changes. What is the changes from its original position to the deflected position? Okay. So next thing is, what are the basic principle present in your structural mechanics? So first of all, in your chapter 1, it consists of many basic principles. So first of all is force, second is moment, third is support conditions, then fifth is conditions of equilibrium, CG, which is known as center of gravity, MI, moment of inertia, and last is free body diagram. Okay. So these are, you are so familiar to these kinds of the terms in mechanics part, engineering mechanics part. So I think it will be easy for you. So first of all, force. So force is nothing but it is a push or pull that acts upon an object. As a result of that object's interaction with its surrounding. Okay, basically your force is two types. One is active force, another is reactive force. So what is the active force? So first of all, the active force tends to the particle in motion, and reactive force is reactive result from the supports and tends to the prevent motion. So you can see here two figure is there. So first of all, it is a hanging a light which situated and hang from a wall. So from wall it gain the reactive force by which the whole light system is subjected to the active force. Okay. So in the second figure you can see a person is there who pulling a weight. So due to the its reactive force generated from the wall or from the floor, okay, by which it can give the react to the object. So that's why it pull up to some distance. Okay. So next thing is the moment. So moment is the turning effect of force applied to a rotational system at a distance from the axis of rotation. Okay. And the moment calculated by force into perpendicular distance. You can see here is a figure, and it is a figure of a slide wrench which working condition to give a moment to a bolt system. Okay. So by a hand you apply a force to the slide wrench by which it can give a moment towards the bolt. So by which it can give a moment. So the next is support condition. Okay, there are so many kinds of support condition, because any structure it require a support by which it can be in a stable condition. So that here three types of support condition is there. First is fixed support condition, second is pin or hinge support condition, and third is rolled support condition. So these are the conditions of support. So first of all, fixed support. Fixed support means it restricted three kinds of forces. First is Rx, means horizontal axis force, then Y axis, that means vertical axis force, and third is the moment. Okay. And next is the pin or hinge support. Another thing is there, the fixed support example is the first figure. Here you can see in the first figure there is here the bolt connection is there, so that it will be fixed in this position. Okay, and other are free from the fixed condition. This portion only on the fixed condition. Okay, the next thing is hinge support. In the hinge support it restricted the horizontal force as well as the vertical force. Okay, so here moment is not restricted. So you can take the example of a door. Okay, door can be moved by the horizontal force as well as the vertical force. And third is your roller support. So roller support, you can in roller support it can be moved only one directional. Okay, so here is the figure of roller support, which is a machine of pulley. Okay, you can see this figure in a pulley, in the wheel, it used as a pulley. Okay, so this is all about your today's class. So thank you so much.